Hi, my name is Brian, and this is my goofy dog, Tucker. And I want to show you a video about a little project I've done, mostly a proof of concept about condensate water harvesting off my air conditioner system. Just a quick basic rundown. What I've got here is nothing complicated. So the air conditioning system, if you know anything about how it works, then you don't need me to explain it to you. If you don't know about how they work, I won't give the ins and outs, but basically one byproduct of your air conditioning system is condensate. The moisture in the air is pulled out of the air that eventually ends up in your home. And it comes out generally out of a drain line like this. It's just simple PVC, and it's pretty much pure water. There might be some minor contaminants, nothing too much to worry about. With any water system, you're going to get mold or bacterial buildup you may need to worry about. Anyway. Barring any kind of weird bacterial thing, you've got pretty much clear water coming out of this drain. So rather than let it drain out into the ground, which is what it typically does, I wanted to harness this water because in the height of summertime, it can be, you know, 5 to 10 gallons a day. So you can water this spot on the ground right here, or you can run it to wherever you want it. So what I've done here is I bought a simple condensate pump. This was from Lowe's. It was $72.99. You can get cheaper models and fancier models, whatever you want to do. Basic operation. This condensate line, clean water coming out of the air conditioner, just comes out of this PVC connection, right? It's not even tied in hard. It's a 90 degree connection. Just friction fits into that hole. This is a little float tank, or a tank with a float switch in it. When that level gets high enough, it's going to pump out of here. And that's just extra in case I need to cut off more later. It pumps out of here with a built-in check valve so it won't let it backflow. I went ahead and ran it through another check valve just for extra peace of mind. But it goes out through a garden hose and to a raised bed garden that I'll show you here in just a second. It runs around the house there and then the garden's on the far side. What I've done is trimmed down an old Rubbermaid bin. So it just fits over as a rain cover. I'm not too worried about overheating in the summertime, generally because this is cold water coming out. So it does a pretty good job of keeping the unit cool. So basic flow path is nothing fancy. Don't expect a really nice system. Basically all I'm doing here is running this through the garden hose across the yard. And it's going to something super simple right now. This is eventually going to be nicer, but as a proof of concept, just to satisfy my own curiosity, this is how I've got it set up. Tried to minimize kinks in the hose so that it kind of runs freely. But this is, and please, I'm not a gardener yet. A lot of these things died when I transplanted. I probably put them in the ground too early. So, first time effort, don't judge me too harshly on what's growing. I'm learning. Anyway, here's my really simple 5 gallon bucket. I got a couple of bulkhead fittings, they're about 10 bucks each. But basically, this hose just comes straight into the top here. Just gravity dumps in there. I'm going to do a little bit more with it, but in super simple process, when it gets to that level of the bucket, it just drains out. Now this is a 50-foot soaker hose. I've run it around the dirt, buried it about an inch deep. I'm going to come back and mulch on top of this later so that it'll all be covered. Won't lose a whole lot due to evaporation. But that's the basic idea. So just gravity drains into the hose. And this is the first day it's been operating. And from what I can tell, the soil is pretty wet here. It feels moist to the touch, kind of like a damp sponge. And all across the bed. Today was the first day that I could kind of get in here and feel. And it looks like there's a good amount of moisture in the soil consistently across the bed. I got a lot of dead things that it's been about 4 days out here getting this figured out, and I think it got really inadequate water supply and transplant shock and whatever else, but 1 for 10 on cucumbers. So again, don't judge, I'm learning. In the bucket also built in an overflow pipe. It's just shy of level with the top of the bucket. So that, you know, it fills up, I don't worry about pressurization yet or whatever else. It'll just dump out the side. So, for the time being, And yes, it'll only get this full. It'll drain out because there's not enough pressure in the hose to let it fill up. I've got better plans for that. I could move this up. I just didn't want too much stagnant water yet. This will eventually be a giant rain tank. You might ask why I'm not doing rainwater harvesting. Well, the place I'm renting doesn't have any gutters, so that's a project for later. Anyway, so this is it. This is my relatively low maintenance raised garden bed. I love the idea of getting fresh food and fresh things from my garden instead of the store. I love the idea of doing this project. And this raised bed was built with some scrap 4x4 pieces for the corners inside and two 10-foot 2x10s and two 10-foot 2x4s. So not a whole lot of complication in this thing. I built it in about an hour. So very simple plans. I'll provide a link to the guy that I got the planned video from. Pretty easy video. I went straight out and built this thing. Works really well. So first attempt at making this thing run. This was the first day I had it running properly and irrigating the bed evenly. So we'll see how it goes. I still need to come back on top and mulch. And I'd like to see these things take off. I think the tomatoes are doing a lot better than the cucumbers. But I'll try to keep you guys updated. For now, I just kind of wanted to get a video out there so you guys could give me some tips and suggestions on how I can do this better. So I really would like some cucumbers. Thanks. Have a good day.